Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. With me, TapersCrazy, where we last left off, we spoke to the rest of Dandelion's cohorts, I guess. Essentially ladies that he had some kind of connection with, and one bloke as well, but dressed like a lady from now every now and again. And what we found out is that everything pointed him in the direction of this one particular bard who we found out has a spectacular singing voice and was bringing everyone to tears with her songs. We went to the, is it called the Kingfisher? Essentially the tavern where she plays and listen to her concert. I guess you can call it a concert. I don't know if I called it concert back in medieval eras. But we'll listen to her nonetheless, and hopefully today we can get an audience with her and see what she knows about Dandelion and take it from there. So let's get stuck into the game. We need to speak to this lady.
I know him. 'Twas him murdered some Temerian boys back in White Orchard.
Silence, woman.
We've come to Jesus.
There's a war on. Some die.
Oh, please, argue this out elsewhere.
Squabbles and rows again. And I was told this was a decent establishment.
If I know Geralt, he risked his noggin to save someone else's arse.
Save, you say? He murdered folk.
Don't let him provoke you.
There's the door. Settle this outside.
Come.
Jesus, isn't she the innkeeper from the very first...
Music. Music.
Cultural capital of the world?
Isn't she the innkeeper from the very first place? As far as I'm aware, I stopped them from, like...
Permit me...
What's the word I'm looking for here? I stopped them from killing you.
This year's persona, known also as Calanetta. As lovely as she is talented. And this...
is Geralt of Rivia, I know. Dandelion's told me a great deal about you, and I've listened with bated breath.
Oh, boy.
Don't be surprised. After all, doubt I could think of a more fitting subject for a ballad than a witch's love for a sorceress.
I thought that was what it was.
Sorceresses.
Hey! Hey! I don't know the history. I know there's a thing between Trissa and, Yennefer. Right, okay. Seems Dandelion left nothing out then.
Seems Dandelion was meticulous in telling my story, down to personal and insignificant details. Did he offer anything about himself, like where he was going?
Splendid! Very funny, truly. So, see you later.
Not here. Come with me.
Right.
There a reason for all this sneaking around?
An excellent one. When last I saw Dandelion, he told me he was planning a heist. Siggy Reuven's vault?
Sheepdip.
And I've not seen him since.
Breaking into a vault.
Dandelion breaking into a vault.
The Novigrad job. We need 3 Mini Coopers. True. And a lot of people with British accents.
He's waiting to pass a floor at once. Need to wait the next 3 nights worrying about it.
Any idea what got into him? He have debts he needed to pay off?
Claimed he was helping someone. Urgent matter that couldn't wait, he said.
This someone, Dandelion mentioned their name?
No. But if I know Dandelion, it's her name he failed to mention. As he failed to mention her slender waist and ample bosom.
Reuven, what's he like?
Tall, fat, dangerous as hell.
Limp in his gait, left leg.
Sounds like a lame rock troll.
If trolls were devilishly intelligent and had a flair for crime, yeah, I'd agree.
Underworld boss.
Let me guess, attempted heist was a failure.
Well, he's not driven up in a gilded carriage laden with jewels, so I should think so. I've asked after him everywhere, but it seems an army of tongue-stealing cats has overrun the city. I learned only that he raised a ruckus at Horson Jr.'s lair. Then Horson's men chased him all over town.
Horson Jr. doesn't ring a bell.
Biggest prick in Novigrad. Not literally, but...
Got it. You're not a fan. But what did he do to you?
try the whole town. He's one of four bosses who control the city's underworld. The others being Siggy Reuven, Carlo the Cleaver Vares, and the King of Beggars.
Oh, I've met the King of Beggars. He seems alright.
Bring that venerable institution into it. We'd be in deep then.
Here I go again, rushing to Dandelion's rescue. He ought to pay me a salary.
Whoever he is, I sincerely doubt he's in the mood for jokes. Nor am I, in fact.
Relax, I'll get him out of this. Gotta talk to this Horson first. And Siggy Reuven. Know where I might find them?
I don't know about Horson, but Reuven runs a bathhouse. Careful, though. He's a dangerous character.
So am I.
I don't doubt it. But Dandelion's not. I beg you to hurry. Let me know as soon as you learn anything.
Ah, she got the hots for him. Well, this is his bathhouse.
Heading back to the Rosemary. Got Poppy to feed. Then I suppose I'll wait. See if our warbler don't come home on his own. Take care now.
Geralt!
How'd you meet Dandelion?
You and Dandelion. How'd you meet?
At a poetry tourney in Elendor. Naturally, I'd already heard much about Master Dandelion. And it proved true. At first, I thought him a bloated, narcissistic buffoon.
Just at first.
Well, only cows don't change their minds. I changed mine when he came to congratulate me. Never expected he could lose so graciously. Dandelion can be irritating, I shan't deny it. Yet, I also know he can be fair and noble at times. Well, I very much doubt I could bear to have him around were it not so.
I see. I get it.
Right, I see.
Take care now.
I'm off to rescue your future husband, then, no doubt. So if it doesn't bang someone else. But right, so the next thing we need to do is head to the bathhouse and talk to Siggy Reuven. And we're still on right track for level cap, which is fantastic. Let's get in this bathhouse place then, shall we? I've got something to say here. It's nothing to do with anything that you guys will notice, but recently I switched our video output cable to my main monitor, and I don't know exactly what the cable itself's called, but I changed from a HDMI to, you know, the white one with the one tooth on one side and loads of teeth on the other side. I changed it to that, and it seems to have kind of screwed up the contrast on my monitor. Like, all the darks seem really dark. So I don't know what's going on with it. It shouldn't affect you guys at all, because really that's just dependent on what sort of output you've got going to your monitor, really. You'd only notice if you have the same cable going as I've got. But the reason I switched was because using HDMI, I needed that port open so I could record off a Nintendo Switch. So if I start seem to complain about darkness, then it might not marry up with what you're actually seeing on screen because of post-editing and just generally what sort of hardware you're watching the series on is probably determinant to how this LP will look. Anyway, let's get stuck in and see if we can get into this bathhouse.
Anybody there? Open up.
Maybe you're so aggressive about it, Geralt. It's like a password or something.
What's the fuss? The bathhouse is closed.
Need to talk to the owner. I know he's here.
I'm not sure that matters, as he's terribly busy.
Busy with what? That's not really gonna go down well, but...
Busy? With what?
Entertaining important guests.
In that case, tell him there's another one at the door. Geralt of Rivia. And I'm not leaving till I see him.
Very well, I shall try. Please wait.
Why would a bathhouse be closed at night?
Siggy Reuven cordially invites you to join him. I'm happen.
Well, I happen to just be happy to meet you. I know that was shit, I'm sorry. I tried thinking on the fly and it didn't work.
We will pass through the dressing room so you can leave your clothes.
Let's go.
Right, okay. Happen the eunuch.
You're equipped. safe.
Fine. Okay. Get you any- Oh, yes! I should just play the entire game in a towel! Jesus, Geralt's seen some shit. Look at all these scars, man. Oh god, this video is not going to be monetized. It's not going to get monetized anyway, but if I did, it would never ever see the light of monetization.
He's full like a horse. Clear that you've not seen Reuben.
Right, okay. Well, at least the game doesn't shy away from this sort of stuff, you know? I mean, it's just titties. Wait, I'm following the wrong guy. I'm following the wrong guy. No, okay, hello. Go speak to this guy. Hopefully he doesn't kill us.
Easy, Cleaver.
Orson Jr.'s a dead man. I'll have my scribe send you a notice.
You don't have a scribe. And we'll eliminate Jr. when, and only when, all of us say aye.
Oh, is he the guy that walked past
Reuben,
the...
Your guest.
The... tavern whilst the bard was singing.
Why the fuck you let him in here? Because I want to talk to him. This is Geralt of Rivia.
Good to see you again.
As always, I'm out of the swiving loop. Who the fuck are you?
Need to talk to Siggy. I'm a witcher. That's probably bad news to say.
Got something to discuss with Dijkstra. I mean, Siggy Reuben.
I think he can wait.
Yeah, probably can. Got intruders. Someone just snuck inside the bathhouse. Several men.
What the fuck's he on about? Plowing fortune teller?
Assassins! Please, no!
Why would you punch a naked lady?
I fucking knew it.
Any weapons tucked away?
Just a few.
Big axe!
First ever party with my prick hanging out.
Really? Why would us fighting Stark Bollock naked? Well, that didn't go to plan, did it?
Good work, gents. Terribly sorry for that incident.
What's going on? This is the most macho thing I've ever done in a video game.
Scum. That's the bottom of who and how right there.
Don't start that again. Especially not in front of our guest.
Them abs though, Jesus Christ.
Right before they attacked. Coincidence? Why do I doubt it?
Let's give him a chance to explain.
Gotta see Horson, talk to him.
I'm looking for Horson Jr.
Interesting. What do you want with him?
I'm looking for someone. I might as well be honest with these guys. I want to stave off this guy's paranoia.
Junior's gonna help me find someone.
Horson's not helped a soul in all his miserable life.
I'll ask him nicely.
See, Cleaver? Perhaps if you'd not called Junior an uncle fucker and asked him nicely, he'd have showed up today.
Gentlemen, you out of your fucking minds? A chat session? Horson's out to get us, and he'll succeed, eventually. We've got to kill him first. So by all means, you sit here, soak, fart, and watch the bubbles rise, while I send my boys to Horson's hidey holes. They'll make some noise, flush the bugger out. And you, geriatric, or whatever your ploughing name is, wanna find Horson? Find me first.
Fair enough.
Any clue on Junior's whereabouts? Be grateful for any lead.
Siggy? It's worth a try. Geralt's got a knack for finding people. and his discreet...
Oh, I see, so do these guys already know Geralt from previous games or lore? I'd imagine so.
Looking on you tomorrow, Francis. Finish our talk.
So how about we get dressed?
Sure. Then we'll talk. In private.
Gotta say, he is a hulk of a man, him though, isn't he? He's huge.
Right mess that was. Never thought I'd be glad to see the man responsible for my taking frequent baths.
If you're any cleaner for it, gotta say it was worth breaking your ankle.
It healed poorly. Can you believe it? I must soak it in hot water at least 6 times a day now. Failing that, it bloody pounds like the bells of Beauclair at dawn.
Sorry to hear that. I assume Geralt's the one that caused that problem.
Sorry to hear that.
You're sorry? Well, consider it resolved then. Now, mind showing some added compassion could mean a miraculous recovery to me.
Listen, Reuven. No, Dijkstra. Just not in the mood for your code names, passwords, and other bullshit. I'm here on specific business. If you want to listen, listen. If not, I'd rather you spared me your wit and threw me out now.
What's the harm? Talk.
You think Cleaver will find Orson?
He might. He might not. But he'll burn down half the city trying. What waste. Leave him to it, I say. Work alone.
Any ideas?
Junior's got areas of the city where he's strong. Penetrate them, look around. But be discreet. None of this speed and fury and swinging your steel cock about.
All right. Intent on... Why is this guy so intent on voiding a war with Horse and... Isn't this like the criminal underworld? They're all supposed to be quite powerful, aren't they?
Pretty clear you and Bedlam don't want a war with Junior. Why?
Expensive?
Let me tell you what I told King Vizimir time and time again. War doesn't solve any problems. It breeds trouble. Trouble you then have to solve by other means. Make no mistake, someone's behind Horson's actions. I'll not end him until I know who.
All right, cool, fair enough. That works for our plans. We need Horson alive as well, don't we?
Your partner's aware of your past? They know you're Sigismund Dijkstra, former head of Redanian intelligence?
Cleaver, Bedlam, and Junior. Well, I'd call them our partners if we built a mill to grind flour for the folk of nearby hamlets. But we just need to stay out of each other's ways, agree from time to time. That doesn't make us partners.
Sounds like standard diplomacy to me.
Was. Bedlam, sure. The others most likely suspect. But we just don't talk about it. No need to.
Right, cool.
Makes sense to ask around, I guess. Junior might be in hiding, but he's got to be collecting income. Couldn't afford to cut himself off.
Gambling. That's his big earner. Junior controls the largest casino in town. I'll never forget. Hierarch Hemelfart raised all kinds of hallowed hell there once. Bugger bet, lost his ruby ring. Then there's the arena in the city's bowels. Betting scheme generates near as much as the casino. They're always looking for hired muscle there. Suppose you could always search Horson's house. Though I doubt you'll find him there. Maybe some clue, though.
Alright, well, where's the casino?
Where's Junior's casino?
Near the Temple Watch Towers. Horson's got nought to do with a casino officially, so careful what you say. Try not to arouse any suspicions.
Right, so I've got to go in and pretend that I don't know that Horson runs the place. Because officially he does not.
Arena sounds promising. Where's that?
Sewers beneath Gildorf, but you'll have to enter through the bits. Endure the stench of poverty on the way. Now, Junior loves a good fight. Wager he'd give a lot to see a real Witcher in action.
Fine. Arena battles. I'd say we've not really done much fighting for the past few episodes. It's all been investigative intrigue, isn't it? Rather than killing monsters.
Mentioned Horson's got a house. Where is it?
Solid townhouse on Temple Isle, just on the other side of the bridge. Wouldn't wager me knickers on finding him there. Junior's not that stupid.
All right, cool. So we've got 3 avenues to follow. Fighting an arena. Having a rummage around the casino. And maybe having a look around his house.
I've no without doubt.
Thanks for your help, Deacon.
Why is he expecting payback? I mean, he came here and tried to kill everyone. Was he expecting us not to try and kill them back?
I know him well. Might figure something out.
And that's where we're going to have to end it, because we're out of time for this video today, unfortunately. So, from the bard's tale, we uncover that Dandelion's got into some serious deep doo-doo by performing some crazy heist, and now it's on us to try and rescue Dandelion to see what he found out about Ciri. So we got pointed into the, I assume, very expansive realm of the criminal underworld of Novigrad, and went to the bathhouse to go speak to Dijkstra, who is one of the criminal overlords that rule this city, to try and figure out what happened to Dandelion, see if he's got any information. And so far, we're not really getting much out of him because we got attacked in the middle of a conversation. So, next episode, we'll speak to a bit more about Dijkstra and see where our conversations with him lead us, and then take it from there. So, anyway, thanks for watching this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.